Welcome to the Student Academic Learning Services video on multiplying fractions. This video builds upon the Introduction to Fractions video, so if you have not watched the Introduction to Fractions video, I strongly suggest you watch that video before continuing on with this video. In order to multiply fractions together, we're going to follow the following three-step method. Step one is to convert all numbers to prime factors and then cancel. Step two, multiply the numerators and denominators together. Step 3, double check to ensure that we're in lowest terms. Let's take a look at this example. Example, we have 4 over 7 times 6 over 10. I've included our method up here in the corner. And step 1 is to convert all the numbers to prime factors and then cancel. So what is a prime number? A prime number is a number that is divisible by only 1 and itself. In order to make our lives a little bit easier, I'm going to include the first few prime numbers. So 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, and we'll say 13. So in order to convert these to prime, we're going to take the first one, 4, and we're going to convert it to the smallest prime numbers that we can. So it's equal to 2 times 2. 6 is equal to 2 times 3. 7's already prime, so we're just going to leave it as is. 10 converts to 2 times 5. Okay? So now what we're going to do is we're going to rewrite our fraction in terms of prime numbers. So 4 converted to 2 times 2, and we're going to multiply that by 6, so 2 times 3. And in the denominator, we had 7 times 2 times 5. Now, we've converted to prime, so our next part of step 1 is to cancel out. So we're going to cancel a 2 on the top and a 2 on the bottom. That's going to leave us with 2 times 2 times 3 on the top and 7 times 5 on the bottom. So we're going to move right to step 2, and we're going to multiply that out. 2 times 2 is 4 times 3 is 12. And on the bottom, 7 times 5 is 35. Now, because we've converted to prime factors and canceled out, our final fraction should be in lowest terms, but as always, we're just going to double check just to ensure that we're in lowest terms. So moving on to step 3, we're going to take the factors of 12. And if you've watched the Introduction to Fractions video or the Adding and Subtraction Fractions video, you already know where this is going. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. And the factors of 35 are equal to 1, 5, 7, and 35 itself. So the only thing common in these lists is 1. Dividing by 1 is not going to change our final fraction. So we can say that 12 over 35 is in lowest terms. Let's take a look at another example. This example, we have 36 over 48 times 10 over 14. I've left our list of prime factors here, and I've also left our method. So step 1 is to convert to prime factors and then to cancel. So 36 converts to 2 times 18, which converts to 2 times 9, which 9 converts to 3 times 3. 10 converts to 2 times 5, like we saw in the last example. 48 converts to 2 times 24. 24 converts to 2 times 12. 12 converts to 2 times 6. And 6 converts to 2 times 3. And lastly, 14 converts to 2 times 7. So what we're going to do now is, because we have so many prime factors, we're just going to go through and we're going to circle each one. This was 2 and 5. 14 was 2 and 7. And 48 was 2, 2, 2, 2, and 3. So now, we're going to rewrite this And we have 2 times 2 times 3 times 3. And 10 converted to 2 times 5. There's our numerator. And our denominator, 48 converted to 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. Let's just double check. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 2s, and 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 3. And 14 converted to 2 times 7. So as you can see, we've just rewritten this fraction in terms of its prime factors. And now we're going to cancel out. So we have a 2 on the top and a 2 on the bottom. A 2 on the top, 2 on the bottom, a 3 on the top, a 3 on the bottom, and then one more 2 up here. So what we're left with is 3 times 5, just going to rewrite it, and 2 times 2 times 7. Okay, so that cleaned up rather nicely. So now our next step is to multiply. Multiplying 3 times 5, that gives us 15. And on the bottom, 2 times 2 is 4, times 7 is 28. So we're left with 15 over 28, and unless we've made a mistake, that should be in lowest terms because we converted to prime factors. So let's just take a look and move on to step 3. And we're just going to list the factors. I'll list them over here. The factors of 15 are 1, 3, 5, and 15. And the factors of 28 are equal to 1, 2, 4, 7, 14, and 28 itself. So you can see we only have 1's common. Dividing by 1 isn't going to change our final answer. So we can state that 15 over 28 is in lowest terms. Let's take a look at one more example. Here we have 54 over 75 times 65 over 90. Step 1 is converting the numbers to prime. So 54 converts to 2 times 27. 27 converts to 3 times 9, and that converts to 3 times 3. 65 converts to 5 times 13. Now just a little note here, this is a rather unique number that its only two prime factors are actually 5 and 13. 75 converts to 3 times 25, and 25 converts to 5 times 5. And lastly, 90 converts to 2 times 45, which converts to 5 times 9, which converts to 3 times 3. So again, I'm just going to go through and circle our prime factors so we make sure we don't forget one. 3 times 5 times 5, and 2 times 5 times 3 times 3. So let's rewrite this in terms of prime factors. So 2 times 3 times 3 times 3. And 65 was 5 times 13. And our denominator is equal to 3 times 5 times 5. And 90 was 2 times 5 times 3 times 3. Okay, so now let's cancel. We have a 2 on the top and a 2 on the bottom. We have a 3 on the top and a 3 on the bottom. We have a 5 on the bottom. Cancel that there. We have a 3 there and a 3 there. 3 on the top and a 3 on the bottom. So what we're actually left with is 13 over 5 times 5. Moving on to step 2, it's just multiplying. 13 is the only number left on top, and 5 times 5 is 25. So now, as always, we want to double check to make sure we're in lowest terms. So we're going to list the factors of 13. Are 1 and 13, and we know that because 13 is actually in our prime factors list. And the factors of 25 are 1, 5, and 25. And it's not surprising that the only thing they have in common is 1. Dividing by 1 is not going to change our final fraction. So we can state that 13 over 25 is in lowest terms. That concludes our video on multiplying fractions. If you have any questions regarding the material covered in this video, I encourage you to come to the SAL Center located in room 204 of the Student Services Building and make an appointment with the appropriate Learning Skills Advisor. Thanks for watching.